Welcome to Professor's Garage. A sealed transmission on your Toyota or Lexus, no dipstick, you still need to change the transmission fluid, starting at 60,000 miles and then every 30,000 miles after that. As I discussed in the other video, you only need to replace the fluid. There is absolutely no need to replace the strainer or filter inside for Toyota transmission. This Lexus is approaching 90,000 miles, and today we are going to replace the transmission fluid for the second time. This video will show you every step to do it, as well as two methods to measure transmission fluid temperature so you have the correct amount of fluid inside. Let's get started. Tools that you need for this job. And supplies. All these are available in the description below. Raise the vehicle so you have enough clearance and make sure it's level so your fluid measurement is accurate. You also need to remove front wheel because that's where you fill the transmission fluid. Double check on safety support before you get under the car. Remove the transmission side cover with the 10mm socket. And remove the filler cap with a 24 socket. Put a catch pan under the transmission and take off the transmission overflow tube plug with the T40 torx bit. Let it drain. This is only the overflow, and it's not all the fluid in the transmission pan just yet. Once this is done, remove the overflow tube with a 17mm Allen bit. Let it drain again. This will drain all the fluid in the pan. Once it's completely drained, replace the overflow tube with a new O-ring. Lubricate the O-ring with fluid. Put it back. And torque it to 36 foot-pounds. Replace the tube plug or drain plug with the new O-ring. Put it back, but don't make it too tight. You will need to remove it again briefly to drain to the correct level. With a funnel or a fluid pump, add about 3.5 quarts of WSATF via the filler hole. Replace the filler cap washer with a new one. Put it back. And it's okay now to torque it to 36 foot-pounds. Or you can torque it later up to fluid level is good. Now start the engine and monitor the transmission fluid temperature until it reaches 104 Fahrenheit or somewhere between 94 and 114 Fahrenheit. Remember, this is only a warm temperature, not the operating hot temperature, so do not make the engine transmission too hot, or you will have to cool it down first. There are three methods to monitor the fluid temperature, and we use two methods in this video. The first method, you can use a scan tool with features to read transmission fluid temperature. This X2D7 has that functionality. Or if you know how to program the transmission temperature PID with the lower end scan tool and the torx app, for example, you may get that done without spending a lot on the scan tool. The second method here is to use an infrared thermometer and measure the transmission external temperature, which should be relatively lower compared to the fluid temperature inside. As you can see here, the reading of the thermometer is multiple degrees lower than the number on the scan tool. The good news is, as long as the temperature is within the 20 degree range, your measurement should be good. So hopefully this gives you some idea. The third method is to follow a special deep procedure prescribed by Toyota or Lexus. You can use a paper clip to jam some of the pins on the car's OBD connector and monitor flashing signals on the dash when it reaches the desired temperature. This is the least expensive method, but it is too much to manage all three methods in one video, so I will focus on the first two. To raise the transmission fluid temperature quickly, with foot on the brake firmly, you may slowly shift gear. When transmission fluid reaches the desired temperature in the range of 94 and 114 Fahrenheit, remove the overflow tube plug and let it drain until the fluid starts to trickle. At this point, replace the drain plug and tighten it to 7 foot-pounds or 84 inch-pounds. You can now shut off the engine, make sure everything is tightened, put the cover back, put the wheel back, have a test drive, and check leaks. Recycle the fluid properly and it will be another 30,000 miles before you replace again. I hope this video is helpful and informative. If it is, please give us a like or subscribe. Stay tuned for future videos on car care and repairs. If a professor can do it, you can do it. Until the next time, may the Lord bless you and give you peace. 平安。